Improved mental health care in the Crescent City has gained a momentum with a public debate brewing over what will happen to the New Orleans Adolescent Hospital uptown. It was closed by the state in 2009. A recent announcement that Children's Hospital had signed a long-term lease for the uptown facility seemed promising, but the hospital said relocating mental health services there just didn't make sense financially. As WDSU reporter Casey Ferran tells us, two state lawmakers are stepping in now to determine what happens next.
This is the best plan that we have seen for enhanced mental health care in the city for both adults and children.
For several months, State Representative Helena Moreno has worked with Children's Hospital to get the now shuttered New Orleans Adolescent Hospital nearby back up and running.
With my particular bill, it allows Children's Hospital to purchase NOAA, and it also lifts the restriction for them to have to provide inpatient psychiatric care at NOAA.
Children's Hospital has wanted to buy NOAA for decades. In January, it signed a long-term lease at $530,000 a year, which would reopen NOAA, providing mental health in and outpatient services similar to what was provided prior to Katrina, something now required by state law.
To put a restriction that we have to provide mental health services, I think is unfair. And the reason for that is, just pan out right here behind me, and you see this building and the one behind you. This campus is providing behavioral health services.
Landry says Children's has 33 inpatient beds, 7 for children, 26 for adolescents, and that the hospital signed the lease to meet the deadline and continue negotiations with the state. He says it was signed with the understanding that the lease could be canceled in June.
And the reason for that was we would have the opportunity to present a bill in the legislature that would lift these owners' restrictions and also allow the state to purchase or to sell the property to us.
In response, State Representative Neil Abramson filed another bill to allow the state to lease the facility to Ochsner or another operator if Children's didn't comply with the lease terms.
Children's has signed a lease saying it's going to open. If for some reason they have changed their mind, then let's give it to somebody who will do the job.
Cecile Thibault, a mental health advocate, says Children's existing mental health program only scratches the surface of what's needed.
The average stay for a child or adolescent going into that hospital is really only 5 days. Mm-hmm. And that really is just more stabilization. That isn't necessarily treatment or long-term treatment.
On your side, in Orleans Parish, Casey Ferrand, WDSU News.
Children's says it's one of the top providers for behavioral health care in the area. In July, we'll add 9 adult beds on the Calhoun campus, which were closed because of state budget cuts. 16 more child and adolescent beds could also be added there.